I think one of the hardest ministries that we have in reality is to not react, but to act in a way that brings out the person, the love, and the compassion of Jesus in such a way that people would see and desire to be like that, and for us to emulate as much as possible the same qualities that God had placed in his son by raising him up to be the man of God that he became. Because Jesus said that he didn't do anything of himself, but he did that those things that the Father was pleased in, that he saw his Father doing, that his Father wanted him to do and to accomplish. And in that, then we see an example that we should live our lives like. And I don't see Jesus, you know, identifying himself with causes or to get involved in all these circumstantial things, but he came with one purpose and one design and one reason and one ideology, and that was to reveal his Father, to show his Father, to demonstrate the love of God, our Father, to the world, that this was the way of salvation, that he could have, we could have a relationship with the Father through that which the Father had provided for in the Son to do and demonstrate that which he had already agreed to volunteer to go and do for us, which was to bring us salvation for our sins, but also to bring us relationship with our Father by way of Jesus through his Holy Spirit, so that we could not be living after the things that we just see, feel, touch, and hear, but that we could know that there's more to life than this literal dog pile that we're living in, that we keep snapping and biting and chewing and barking and acting like it's the end of the world, of this being our world. And it's not. This isn't our home. This isn't what we were destined for. This isn't what we were meant to be, even though we get caught up in it. So there are times where we need to go back to the basics, to just get into the Word, you know, get into the Bible, get into reading and knowing that there is a place that God has said that you can be filled with his Spirit, which is by hearing the Word of God and by letting it come into you, change your mind, that you might be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you might prove what is the perfect and acceptable will of God in Christ Jesus. And that comes through a metamorphosis, an infusion, as it were, a transformation by way of the Word of God coming into you, causing you to be changed in the way that God meant it to be. Because it's not a book of philosophy and it's not a book of history. It is a miraculous ability that God has to use his Word to accomplish his purpose, designed to do something in you that will cause a inward reaction that is spiritual, that will manifest itself in an outward action of you being changed into the image of his Son. It's all boiled out and pretty simple, right? The Bible is not just addressed to anybody. Tozer. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our Lord shall stand forever. That many people find the Bible hard to understand will not be denied by those acquainted with the facts. I venture to give a short answer to the question, why is the Bible hard to understand? I believe that we find the Bible difficult because we try to read it as we would read any other book, and it is not the same as any other book. The Bible is a supernatural book and can be understood only by a supernatural aid. It is not addressed to just anybody. Its message is directed to a chosen few. Whether those few were chosen by God in a sovereign act of election or are chosen because they met certain qualifying conditions, I leave to each one to decide as he may. And you can determine that for yourself, by if you're chosen or not. But whatever may have taken place in eternity, it is obvious what happens in time. Some believe and some do not. Some are morally receptive and some are not. Some have spiritual capacity and some have not. It is to those who do and are and have that the Bible is addressed, to those that it is a spiritual book that causes an interaction and reaction in them to cause them to come to a place of relationship with God. Those who do not and are not and have not will read it in vain. The saving power of the Word is reserved for those for whom it is intended. The secret of the Lord is with them that fear him. The impertinent or impenitent heart will find the Bible but a skeleton of facts without flesh or blood or life or breath. And in that, sometimes I have to even acknowledge to myself when I deal with people in general that there are some who will not be saved. And that's sad, because I would that all men would come to the realization of the knowledge of Jesus Christ and thereby grow in that so that they would come to the place of salvation, that God would save them from themselves and their own choices that they've made, and cause them to bring to a realization the fact that they need God to avoid the place of condemnation, which God will condemn those who do not know His Son to hell. God forbid that any we know or even ourselves be found in such a place. So we need to read the Word, study the Word, let it fill us and fill our mind with the mindset that when our words would come out would even be the Word of God being spoken, so that others would hear it, so it would be hearing of the Word of God as it is related to others in the way that God would have it to be by His Holy Spirit, causing them to not only hear it from us but to be receptive from it, because they have the Holy Spirit in them and it is joined in one unity of the faith, whereby it causes a spiritual dimension to have a reality in your life. If you understood all that, praise the Lord. If not, oh well.